Hi friends, I have tons of requests do a square video. So here it is. I've talked about why Square is led by one of the most awesome CEOs, Jack Dorsey, in this video up here with like 160k views. I've also talked about Square's crazy mission in this video here with also 100 over k views. I'll put all the links below. I showed you guys how much I invested in Square previously. Nothing changed. And in this video, I'll talk about why I doubled my price target to $475. I just want to be upfront. Honestly, I think Square stock price is a little bit overpriced, but it's not unrealistic looking at the amount of stimulus money out there. Having said that, overpriced doesn't mean I'll sell. Timing the market have proven over and over and over again to be dumb. So for the 100th time, dollar cost average is the best strategy. Doing nothing and get rich sounds awesome, right? As always, let's apply first principles. Ask the relevant questions. In this video, I will specifically cover Square's Cash App. What problem does Square's Cash App solve? If you have a digital wallet that allows you to buy groceries, send money to family and friends, get discounts, buy stock and Bitcoin, travel without changing currency. So think about it, there is literally no more reason to remove money out of the Cash App system, and this is where all the money will be at. Seriously, think about it. You go to Walmart for your grocery shopping, you use Cash App. You want to split a bill with your friends eating at a restaurant, you use Cash App. Let's say during the meal with your friends, you talk about investments and you use Cash App to buy the stock or Bitcoin. How about traveling? Think about the money saved and taken away from the big industries of foreign exchange. As mentioned in my previous video, if you solve all the problems related to money, your platform will be essentially where all the money be at. This was Elon's goal back at PayPal before they kicked him out. Oh yeah, appreciate an early thumbs up, it really helps a lot in the channel. Looking at Google Trends, you see how fast Cash App gained traction during this COVID crisis. This is important because it proves how essential the service is. This is how a new customer looked like after 6 months using the Cash App. Initially, they deposited some money inside here and they do some sort of investments. After 6 months, they are using the Cash App to do so many more things. And because of this, every new customer acquisition brings massive revenue to Square's ecosystem. Now let's talk numbers. Cash App downloads, you see over the years, every year increasing about 30 million. This is Cash App's revenue per user. In 2017, it was $15. In 2019, it was $30 per user. Putting it into a graph form with my favorite site, Hyperchart, you will notice the growth of the monthly active users on Cash App. When you scroll down, here you can easily see where are the revenue segments from. They have mainly four revenue segments represented by the four different colors. You will realize that the Bitcoin ecosystem brought Cash App a lot of money. The four revenue generators for Square is transactional based revenue, subscription and SaaS revenue, hardware revenue and Bitcoin revenue. I have placed all these numbers in my evaluation spreadsheet. Number one is transactional based revenue, both offline and online where customers swipe their cards. Next is subscription service based revenue. I had to split this both apart. So the first part will be the Cash App, excluding Bitcoin revenue. And second will be Square's Capital, where they provide loans, SaaS like the Webly online portal and other stuff they have here. Next is hardware revenue. This is where they sell hardware for people to transact. Lastly is Bitcoin revenue. All the numbers here are in the millions. CAGR refers to compound annual growth rate. I derive CAGR from past growth rates. For transactional based revenue growing at 18% a year, that is pretty a normal growth for Square. For this section here, it is only at 5% because if you look at the past, the growth in that much. However, if you look at Cash App revenue growth, this is crazy. That's why I separated both of these. Hardware revenue growth at 18% a year and Bitcoin revenue growth at 80%. I highlighted these two sections because when you compound it so quickly, the numbers become a bit unrealistic and I give it a massive discount. I believe after a certain point, the curve will flatten. Cash App is a massive growth driver for Square. And because of that, I have to revise my price target. Putting the new numbers in, how did I derive at such a revenue? You need to take a look at the active monthly users. And I give the active monthly users at a annual growth rate of 20%. So 24 million, 41 million, and 71 million. So you compound it by 20% a year, and these are the numbers you get. And over here is the revenue per customer. So this is how I derive the numbers over here on total revenue for Cash App. And if you add up everything over here, you get the total revenue. So by the time year 2025 reaches, the total revenue for Square will be at $42 billion. If you look at Square's price history from 2016 to now, I will conservatively take a price ratio of 5 to calculate the stock price for Square in 2025. How do we derive the value of the shares in 2025? We take the total revenue of $42,739,000. You apply a price ratio of 5, and this is the number you get for market cap, and you need to divide by the number of outstanding shares at 449, assuming 2% dilution a year, and you get $475. Just yesterday, news of Square buying 50 million Bitcoins brought the stock up to all-time high. Square is trying to answer one of the most fundamental questions. How do we create a currency without borders to massively solve a very huge problem? So the most viable solution so far is cryptocurrency. Square believes that cryptocurrency is an instrument of economic empowerment and provides a way for the world to participate in the global monetary system, which aligns with the company's purpose. Wrapping up, Square's fundamental is pretty much intact, and the only time I sell is when the fundamentals change for the worse. So I'm still not selling despite that itch. If Square drops 50%, I'm 100% fine. Short-term mindset kills. I know in 5 to 10 years, Square stock price is going to be much higher. I hope you enjoyed this video. Appreciate the thumbs up, and I hope you learned something. Invest safe, and don't be a donkey.